Hello friends, welcome to Dragon Quest 1, being the first chapter of the legendary Erdrick Saga. I don't know what that kanji says. Possibly Dragon Quest? You may be seated. This is the Super Famicom port of the original Dragon Quest, first published in the US as Dragon Warrior. This is a fan translation that came out around 2002. This is my favorite version of the game. I was talking a big game about Dragon Quest the other night during the Super Win the Game stream. And I thought I should put my video game where my mouth is and play through the first Dragon Quest. This port changes a lot of things from the original, mostly balance changes to make it not unbearably tedious, which is nice. One of the main qualities I look for in a video game is not being unbearably tedious. For reasons that are too complicated to explain right now, I will name my character Bort. You have 8 characters to work with, but it only shows the first 4 on the battle screen anyway, so you probably want to pick a name that looks good when truncated to 4 characters. I will go with Fast Message Speed. This will be a pretty leisurely playthrough. So yes, Bort is the descendant of the legendary Erdrick. And yet, this is the first chapter of the Erdrick Saga. Curious. So, right off the bat, this fan translation goes for a few... it makes some choices. I'm sure the fan translators would justify it as being, quote-unquote, de-censorship. Of course, Nintendo was opposed to religious references in video games, so all of those were taken out. I don't really consider that censorship. I think that's more just a localization choice, but the fan translators decided to, I assume, be faithful to the original script, for better or for worse. Some points that would be for better, at some points that'll be for worse. There's some crummy dialogue in this version, in this translation of this version of the game, but we will soldier on. I don't think this is necessarily crummy, putting back in the religious references. I don't think that's a big deal. Like, they could have just used the script from the NES version and it would have been fine, but whatever. So pretty similar script. I'll probably be talking to everyone, unlike when I did the randomizer, because I was sort of going for speed. But this will be a nice leisurely playthrough. This version of the game shouldn't take more than 7 hours, even if I go extra slowly. I'd like to talk about what I like about the game, sort of defend my enjoyment of this game. So, yeah, being a Super Nintendo game with 4 face buttons, you no longer have to go into the menu to talk to people and open chests and everything. There is an action button, which is the Y button on the SNES controller or Super Famicom controller. No, I don't know about Princess Gwaelyn. Why don't you tell me? Not a good sign. You should talk about what's bothering you, buddy. All that pressure is going to build up and explode someday. So, it won't actually let me save my game yet. If you're not using save states, the only way to save is by coming back and talking to the king. What? I found the torch. Oh, I found the magic key. So Dragon Warrior on the NES had about a million frames of lag anytime you push a direction button. If you weren't moving, if you are moving, you can change direction pretty quickly, but it, like, say you're standing still and you decide to go right, you have to hold the right button for like a full second before it registers. So much better controls. This version is just better overall. It streamlines everything. It removes hours and hours of tedious grinding that serve no purpose. If you want to play the original Dragon Quest, I would say this is the version to play. Yes, I do know. You just told me. Well, I'll do my best. Note that the dialogue doesn't wrap super elegantly. This is an early fan translation, so some hacky elements are present. It doesn't detract from the game at all. Valuable advice. I did. Aww. So yeah, just walk up to a door and hit triangle. Also, there's no stairs option. You just walk downstairs by walking into them, which is how it should have worked to begin with, but you know. Early times. Yep, that's what fella number one just said. Oh. So, you move in sort of weird half-step increments in this version, which I don't really understand why they did it that way. All it does is make it a little bit more difficult to line up when you want to talk to someone or examine something. I'm using the version that has the Dragon Warrior names, so the castle is Tantagel, the town is Breconary. There is a version that uses, I guess, delocalized names if you would rather do that. The town is called Ratatome, or I think the castle and the town are both called Ratatome in that version. It was a paradise before all the demons appeared. Consider it forgotten. So this version adds some stuff you can search, like these pots. Not a ton of stuff to find. But hey, it's something. I found a medical herb. Scarred on me, sir. Thank you. So yeah, one medical herb in three pots. Filled with the powers of the darkness. You know, it's not just a place where there's no sunlight. It's magical darkness. Yeah, that tracks. This guy's bummed out. So, of course, you can talk to this guy and refill your MP if you had any. Also, when I played the randomizer, I was using the flag to disable flashing effects, and there's no way to do that in this version, so there will be some brief flashes, so warning about that going forward. I didn't hear. Ooh. Is that it? Tell me more. Oh. Nothing to find in this little indoor pool. So no magic key means we cannot raid the treasury just yet. Good to know. Your feelings? Sure, blame it on the demons. Wow, dude. Way to be optimistic. Unfortunately, if you press the action button when you're not in an action position, it'll just search uselessly. I think all of the SNES Dragon Warrior games might be like that. I don't know if they disabled the action button when there's nothing to action until 7. So we are on the normal vanilla map. Breconary is right next to Castle Tanagel, and Demon Lord's castle is right across the river. I think it was really, really smart design choice to, you know, have it visible on the very first map screen. I have to keep pressing a direction to hide the status box. But yeah, you can see right there your ultimate goal at the end of the game. So close and yet so far away. If only they had invented boats by this point in history. Thank you. I will talk across the counter. Good advice. Can't examine the tombstone. Oh, thank you. What say you, merchant? Hey, I've heard of that place. Boy, I feel that. Very unlikely that you're going to get cursed in this game, because the cursed items are called Cursed Belt and Death Necklace, and most people are wise enough not to equip those. I do have proof. Whatever. I don't need to prove myself to you. So, this is a weird thing. I assume this was in the original Dragon Warrior, Dragon Quest for the NES, and they removed it for the US version. But yeah, she follows you around because you're a handsome stud. Whatever that means. I did. I like the little shake effect there. What you got, item store? Okay. Do I want to spend 20 gold, 20 of my precious G on a dragon scale in this version of the game? I don't think I do. I think I might want to do that. Well, and the randomizer, that's usually the only armor you can afford in the first town you see. And it's not very effective. So I think typically the best move is to save up for the Copper Sword. Because it's way better than the club. And just do without armor for a little bit. But I don't want to do a whole lot of grinding. And this version of the game, it pretty much negates any grinding that you have to do, which is good, because grinding is bad. That's why they call it grinding. It's a grind. It's unpleasant. It's a chore. It's tedious. And I don't know how people came around to liking grinding in video games. I never understood it. The nice thing about RPGs is that if you get to a point where you are underpowered and you can't think of a strategy that will help you proceed, you have the option of grinding and becoming more powerful just through a time investment. But I don't think it should ever be required to grind in a game. In any game. Like, it's become a thing even in, you know, non-RPGs now. Or I guess every game is sort of an RPG. Yeah, not a fan of grinding. So in the NES version, there's no need to equip things. You just buy them and they go into that equipment slot. And the shopkeeper, I'm pretty sure the shopkeeper will buy whatever you have equipped in that slot. So, I will start out with some leather clothes and a bamboo pole. You know, the club is only two more than the pole, so the pole should be fine for now. Alright, I think I talked to everyone. Everyone I have access to. Oh, not this guy. I bet he's sad about Princess Gwaelyn. No wonder you can't rescue her with that attitude. See, all of the NPCs move in one block increments. No half block movements for them. Okay, well, let's see if I can make it to the next town. If not, then I get teleported back to the king and I lose half my gold. Which right now is not that much. Oh, I forgot about one of the most important changes in this version of the game. Oh, hang on. I have to kill a red slime. So the amount of experience you get is greatly boosted. The experience curve actually makes sense and feels fine. Oh, I didn't talk to this guy either. Good advice. So inside the inn, there's also a bank for a vault. So I will deposit nothing because I forgot it's only increments of 1,000. They change that in later installments. If I die right now, I will lose 22 gold, which is not a big deal in the grand scheme of things. Alright, onward to adventure. Love this version of the world map music. A ghost. A ghost. Took 3 damage, hit for 1. Doesn't seem like a great ratio for me. I might try to run away from the ghost. Dang. I already got my butt kicked. Okay, well, maybe I should grind just a little bit. Fight some slimes. Of course, what I'm doing right now isn't grinding because I'm going back to the inn to rest. See, I don't consider that grinding because I'm encountering enemies on my way to a place. Like, I have a goal, I'm not just walking around in circles. So, in a well-balanced game, you can, you know, push forward a little bit, explore, run up against, you know, a barrier where you're outclassed and have to turn back and gain experience that way. Unlike in the original Dragon Warrior, where you pretty much have to walk back and forth fighting enemies for hours before you can even go to the next area. Only 3 gold to rest instead of 6 in the original. Which is nice. It's nice that you have a nice cheap rest option. Of course, as soon as I learn heal, I won't have to stay at an inn. I can just go to the castle, talk to the bishop or the priest or whoever, and cure myself and immediately get my magic points back. No damage, nice. And already leveled. Alright. Pretty good gains there. So, if I'm not interrupted by ghosts, I can go on ahead and pop into the first dungeon. So you have a nice little radius of light. I think it's more than you get in Dragon Warrior. I think the one in Dragon Warrior is 3x3, and this one is more like 7x7, sort of. You know, not exact, because it's a circle, not a square. Also, going into a dungeon doesn't tank your frame rate in this version of the game. And the first dungeon has no monsters in it. They added some decorations, which is a nice little touch. It's hard for me to get a good audio mix in this game, because I feel like this track is significantly louder than like the overworld music. And I have a balance so that this hopefully isn't overpowering my voice, but the overworld music is probably difficult to hear. And that is the symbol of Erdrick, or Loto, if you're using the Japanese name. You can see that represented in my background. I don't recall exactly when the symbol became a thing, but it's a thing now. It wasn't a thing in the NES version. Oh, hi. Alright, I will do what you say. Can I collect all of these herbs that are growing around the tombstone? No. Eh. Cave herbs are probably no good anyway. Ow, 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 ow. The thud when you walk into walls is a lot more like rapid fire in this version. I guess that's to match the increased walking speed. So yeah, that's all there is. This is Erdrick's cave, or Erdrick's tomb. It's like a tutorial. Like, this is how dungeons work. You light a torch, you tumble around in the dark, and Eventually, you might find something. I can probably take a Drachi. That went okay. Nice tolerable encounter rate in this game, which can't be said for a lot of games of this era. And I think it was similar on the Famicom, on the NES. I don't think the encounter rate was anywhere near as bad as like Final Fantasy 1. Of course, it's kind of a double-edged sword because that increases the amount that you had to grind. Like, just the amount, like, this game probably took, I think it took like 40 hours if you knew what you were doing on the NES. You know, playing vanilla without any mods or anything. And they cut that in like an eighth just by, you know, changing the experience curve. Wild. Sure, I'll hear your song. Oh, that's not a good song. Keep at it. How much does it cost to rest here? 6 gold. Thank you. I hope nothing bad befalls you either. Nothing in this tree. Similar stuff for sale. And some more stuff that I'm not even close to being able to afford. But I will be. Yeah, I saw it. Cool story, bro. You liar. Yeah, there's a brave person. Sure, I'll let him know. I'm going ahead and buy another torch to replace the one that I used. I don't know if I'll make it to another cave in this video, because I'm probably going to try to shoot for an hour per video. But when I do get to a cave, I'll be prepared. Red Slime at night. Erdrick's Delight. Red Slime gets slain. Erdrick's Pain. That's how that goes. Well, I checked out that portion of the map, and lots of ghosts. It's not that many ghosts. Pretty much just the one ghost. So let's rest up, and I should save my game. And we will continue exploring in another direction. Does this guy look mad? I guess he's not. He looks kind of like he has angry eyebrows, but it's just a pixel effect. Good sprite design in this game. Hello. Aw, the king's delighted. So nice of him. It has certainly been recorded. These three pots might actually be the only new searchable items in the game. Which, if that's the case, is pretty funny. I don't remember running into anything else like that in a dungeon. And certainly not on the overworld. So you may notice that I have to select a target when I attack it, even though there's only one target in each battle. And it also tells me that there's only one red slime when it's not possible for there to be more than one in this game. That's because the same engine was used for Dragon Warrior 2, which is also on this cartridge, or on this ROM. And that's also why my character information box up there is aligned to the left. Because in Dragon Warrior 2, you have three party members, and their three information boxes are across the top of the screen. I don't know why they use that one and not, like, the middle one, so it's centered. It does look a little off-kilter, but that's just how it was done. Miss? I like how you know exactly what happens in a battle just by the sound effects. Like, you don't really need the text that much, which is why I have it at the maximum speed. Max MP. Yay, I learned heal. Alright, I can save 3 gold every time I need to heal. You have a nice background for the mountains now. In the original Dragon Quest, there was exactly one background. And it was like, it's the grassy tree one. In this, you have different backgrounds for each type of terrain. So even though I got 4 MP on that last level up, huh. I thought in Dragon Warrior 1, when you get MP on a level up, it's immediately added to your total. Might be making that up. Oh well. So I guess I have to rest one more time. But the reason I was over there in the mountains was because I was curious if they slow you down in this version the way they do in the original. It doesn't look like it. In the NES version, walking in the mountains, it slows you down by, you know, a frame or two each step. You encounter more enemies and different enemies depending on what terrain you're in. Actually, not sure how the math works out. I think the encounter rate is roughly tied to the terrain, like the encounter zones. The boxes sort of match the way the terrain is laid out, but might not be like exact. So really snappy battles in this, which I like. Every battle just takes a couple seconds. Unless I start fighting something that's too tough for me. See if I can take a ghost. Oh, that's another difference between this and the NES version. In the NES version, you always attack first, except for the surprise round. If the enemy gets a surprise round on you, it attacks first, but otherwise you always go first. And this time, the ghost is sometimes attacking first, so I suppose It's based on one of my stats. Probably agility. So my defense is the same as my agility. Which is strange. I thought it should be my agility plus the value of whatever my armor is. Which means my defense should have been 11. Oh, that's right. It's half of your agility plus whatever the value of your armor is. Half rounded down. So 3 plus 7. Or no, 3 plus 4 is 7. And then your attack is your strength plus the value of your weapon. So I get 2 for the bamboo pole. So pretty simple formulas to understand. Oh yeah, in this version the dragon scale goes in your accessory slot. It doesn't take up an inventory slot. So it would actually be a good idea for me to buy that, I think. So let's head back to the castle, heal up, get my MP back, and I'll go buy the dragon scale. See, I haven't been doing any grinding. I've just been walking around and deciding where to go. That's not grinding. That's the wrong button, though. Alright. Heal thyself. Talk to this gentleman. When the Dragon of Darkness spreads its wings, it marks the arrival of the descendant of Erdrick. May the light shine upon the Darkness God Almighty. May the light shine upon the hero of legend, Bort. The sprite is properly drawn to have the sword in the right hand, no matter which direction you're facing, which is nice. It's not just mirrored, which I think that's the case in the original too, but that's always a nice touch. Right, dragon scale. What town is this? Breckenary, that's right. Oops. Actually, I'm curious if the effect of it is actually shown in this version. I think in the NES version, it increases your defense a little bit, but it's not actually reflected in your stats. So, I guess equip is only located under the status menu. Huh. So it just shows question marks there. Okay. So it gives me 1 point of defense and it shows up on the stat screen. Marvelous. Also, I wish there was a button for back out of all menus, which is something that some of the later games have, instead of just returning to the previous level of menu, it drops you back to them. No. It immediately exits all menus, which is handy, but not a deal breaker. Love that slanted exclamation point. This iconic font work in the Dragon Quest games. Slime defeated? Don't you mean thou hast done well in defeating the slime? I do kind of miss the silly old English affect. Ooh, a magic Draki. This might be bad for me. Eh, one. Might cast Hurt on me, but that would do like 8. I didn't see how much that did. It went by too quickly. Maybe I should drop the speed down to 7, because this is actually pretty fast. So, if the Magidraki goes first this round, then I'm dead. Otherwise, I'll make it through. Thank goodness. Also, the fireball did 8. They changed it from Hurt to Fireball, which is strange. I would have thought this version of the translation would keep the original Dragon Warrior names. But I guess not. Oh yeah. Big risk, big reward. Speed went up. Earned fireballed. Alright, now to retreat back to the castle with my tail between my legs. But hey, I'm not grinding. Oh yeah. That's right, Bort took no damage. Bort just gained 2 speed. Bort is a dodging beast. Look at all that agility, my gosh. Enough to give me a whole extra point of defense. I feel bad for the slimes. But you know, if I don't slay them, their population is just going to explode and they'll run out of resources. I can only enter the town on that one tile. How am I doing on gold? 129, still not enough to buy the better sword. And still barely a tenth of what I need to put it in the bank. Maybe the bank's not as useful as I thought. Well, it is useful once I start collecting key items, just to get stuff out of my inventory, because you do have limited inventory space. Alright, well, that dude wasn't lying. I crossed the bridge, and I had to fight a Magidraki. But I have enough magic to cast 2 heals now, which means I might be able to make it to the next town. Won't that be exciting? Or the next dungeon, at least. Ooh, scorpions are tough. Yeah, 1 damage. However, I have fireball, and scorpions, as we all know, are weak to fire. 17 damage. I always like the experience and the gold scorpions give you in this version of the game because they're both square numbers. I don't know. That tickles me. So the next cave would be the mountain cave. Or the next dungeon is the mountain cave, which is right around here somewhere. A little further south, I reckon. Oh, that seems like something I shouldn't be fighting right now. Let's fireball it. Oh, that only costs 2. Pretty reasonable. Oh, that was a lot of damage. I'm gonna YOLO it. I have been killed. I flew too close to the sun. Oh, thank you, King. Yeah, well, you know, it's a long way to Tipperary. Yes, I'll save my game. Okay, so maybe I will have to do a little bit of grinding. Because I am not yet equipped to take on skeletons. But if I can hang out right around the opening to that bridge, fight Magidrakes, then it shouldn't be too long before I'm strong enough to fight skeletons. And I can buy a better sword. Which, you know, a better sword wouldn't have helped me in that situation, but as soon as I buy better sword, I can start thinking about buying better armor. So yeah, I just lost half my gold, which sucks. I could have bought the better sword by now. But it's just a temporary setback, and that's what's nice about Dragon Quest. Never game over. So you can do things like, you know, explore a little further than you maybe should be able to, and see what's there. Instead of, you know, taking one step into the stronger enemy zone and immediately getting owned and losing, you know, hours of progress. Now, should I use my magic casting fireballs? The Magidraki might be resistant to fire, I'm not sure. There we go. Nice strength gains. No new spell. Well, let's heal myself. Make sure I don't die if I'm ambushed by a Magidraki. And see if I can fight one or two more of those. Or a scorpion. That's also good. Yeah, 25 gold per scorpion. I'll have enough for that sword in no time. Alright. Time to briefly run away. I wonder if Japan ever had slime-themed promotional Hershey's Kisses. I assume they did. If they have Hershey's Kisses in Japan, they almost certainly had a crossover promotion like that. Because Dragon Quest has a crossover promotion with everything in Japan. And that's just too perfect. Like a little blue foil-wrapped Hershey's Kiss with like two eyes and a big smile. Ooh, I am almost in sword territory. Let's go fight a couple monstros real quick. Buy that sword. Four gold? No. That's not enough because I had to pay to rest. However, one more red slime. I'm there. Also, there are fewer encounters in the area around the castle, which is nice of them. Now I want Hershey's Kisses. Oh well. Yes, I'm aware of how shops work. Copper Sword. Double my attack. Not really. Thank you. You can have this bamboo pole. I'm done with it. It's gently used. You only have to clean a little bit of slime off of it. Terrific move! My god. Somebody called Guinness. Might be the record-breaking move for terrificness. So now the question is, how far do I want to try to push it? Do I want to try to keep pushing south? Maybe get owned by a skeleton? Ow. I mean, I have enough MP to cast a few heals. Yeah, let's do it. Let's push the envelope. Should still probably fireball the scorpion, though. I guess calling the spell Hurt wouldn't make much sense now that there's an actual sprite for the attack. Okay, how much is the skeleton going to hurt me? Alright, so I can hit it for 5. Ow. Thank god. 42 gold. Not bad. Probably start thinking about better armor soon. Also, I might want to stock up on some herbs. Or herbs, if you're in the UK. The ghost didn't see me. It must be my ingenious camouflage. Goldman. Well, what does that say? Is it defending? I cannot fight a Goldman yet. That's just silly. At least it doesn't make me select a target for the heal spell. Knows I'm the only target for that. Alright. Actually, let's see how much damage I deal with Scorpion. Just for funsies. 4? Yeah. I don't know exactly how much health a Scorpion has. Love that jingle. Love to hear it. Ah, that would be the mountain cave. Huh. I think I'm going to try to upgrade my armor before I take a gander in the mountain cave. Not because I think I need it necessarily, but more to get the gold out of my inventory in case I die. It takes me 3 hits to kill a scorpion. That's not great. Yeah, the mountain cave is pretty far south. Hey, I guarded. Nice. Yeah, it's a small difference. The fact that you don't always for the first round, but it makes a pretty big tactical difference when you're thinking about what to do. Like, I actually have to consider that the enemy might go first, and I don't really have a good way to predict whether it will or not. So if I know something is within killing range, I might have to heal instead of YOLOing it, just because of the possibility of, you know, it attacking first. So yeah, I'm not sure I like that aspect. Look at all that G. Well, let's see. I have leather clothes, so I guess the only armor upgrade I can get at this point is the leather shield. But between my armor, shield, and my accessory, I should be rocking a pretty good defense right now. Heck yeah. I like that it lists my class as hero. Even though that's the only class there is. It's the only class that exists at this point in history. You're either a hero or you're an NPC. If I could look at the NPC stats, it would probably list their class as NPC. Apparently, slimes canonically taste like lime. I think Yuji Horii said that once, and I don't know if it's because slime rhymes with lime, or if there's another rationale for it. I would have assumed they taste like something blue. Also, I don't know if it's just the blue slimes that taste like lime, or if the red ones do as well. Alright, so what's the next upgrade I should be shooting for? Probably the chainmail. If possible, in a Dragon Quest game, you should always upgrade your weapon before your armor. Which, I might do that if I can gather 560 gold. Although, since you don't always attack first in this, maybe that changes the calculus. Maybe sometimes it is better to upgrade your armor first. Hey, I can one-shot a Magidraki. Draki. I always go back and forth on how it should be pronounced. I'm pretty sure it should be Draki, like Dracula. Because they're clearly vampire bats, but they're also slightly dragon-like, which makes me think of drakes. Scorpion didn't see me. Even with a surprise round, it takes me 3 hits. That's okay. Maybe I should have stocked up on herbs while I was in town. Ow. hurt. Even with armor, the skeleton still did 20 damage to me. Good grief. Alright, well, we will very cautiously explore the mountain cave next time on Dragon Quest Z. I mean, 1.